Hello, everybody. Good morning. Oh, man. Arrgh. I hope everyone is having a happy Sunday, a great weekend. Hope everyone's week was fantastic. Welcome. You know, we're gonna play one more song. Nah, it's fine. Let's get to some Phoenix Wright, shall we? Let's, transition over here. Bum bum dum! Good morning! Do some adjustments here. Okay. Dun, 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 dun. Got some bopping music. Good morning, everyone. My name is Swedish Ninja Fish, and we are playing Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney. We're doing the whole series, so we're gonna be doing the whole trilogy, and then there is a game coming out in July, and we will continue that as well, which is kind of a spin-off, I guess, of Phoenix Wright. I have never played this game. It was recommended and requested to me by a friend of mine, and I'm very excited. It's gonna be very fun. We'll be playing Pokemon Nuzlocke later, in about 2 hours for the latter half of the stream. And yeah, that's what I got. So I think I'm going to turn down the volume just a smidgen more here. Down to 22, 23. Some good volume on that. Okay, that should be good. Can change it as we go. Let me go full screen here because it's on the Switch, so I have to use Streamlabs. All right, let's just get into it. So I know very little about this game. I know it's like a visual kind of novel, kind of like what we did with Batman. And you know, go through the story, and I think there's like puzzles and other things like that. So yeah, should be good. Let's get started. So this is the first game in the trilogy, Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney. This is episode 1, the first turnabout. No spoilers, please. And let's go. We're playing on the Switch. Gasp! Gasp! Oh no! Amoide! Damn it! Why me? I can't get caught. Not like this. I've gotta find someone to pin this on. Someone like him. I'll make it look like he did it. Mwahaha. August 3rd, 9:47 a.m. District Court, Defendant Lobby Number 2. Boy, am I nervous. Right. Oh. Hi. Oh, hiya, Chief. Whew. I'm glad I made it on time. Well, I have to say, Phoenix, I'm impressed. Not everyone takes on a murder trial right off the bat like this. I say it says a lot about you and your client as well. Thanks. Actually, it's because I owe him a favor. A favor? You mean you knew the defendant before this case? Isn't that like a no-no, too, technically? Yes. Actually, I kinda owe my current job to him. He's one of the reasons I became an attorney. Well, that's news to me. I want to help him out any way I can. I just really want to help him. I owe him that much. It's over. My life, everything, it's all over. Oh dear. Is that your client screaming over there? Yeah, it's him. Death, despair! Oh! I'm gonna do it! I'm gonna die! Sounds like he wants to die. Yeah. What is happening? Oh my god, look at his eyes. They sparkle. You think so? See, I thought that was a thingy. I don't know. Maybe not. I thought that was, like, a thing. Like, because it wouldn't it be, like, a conflict of interest or something? Or am I thinking of something else? I don't know. Oh, gotcha. Nick! Hey there, Larry. Is his last name Butts? Is that why it says Butts? Larry Butts. Oh my god. Wait, so my name's Nick? I thought my name was Phoenix. I'm so confused. Dude, I'm so guilty. Tell them I'm guilty. Give me the death sentence. I ain't afraid to die. What? Hello? What? What's wrong, Larry? Oh, it's all over. I'm finished. Finished! I can't live in a world without her. I can't. Who took her away from me, Nick? Who did this? Aw, Nick, you gotta tell me. Who took my baby away? Wow, this guy. That, man. This is great. The person responsible for your girlfriend's death? The newspapers say it was you. Thinking voice. My name is Phoenix Wright. Apparently also Nick. And is he saying like Nick, like Phoenix, like I don't know, but that doesn't make sense to me. Phoenix. Okay. Anyways, here's the story. My first case is a fairly simple one. The animation is so good. A young woman was killed in her apartment. The guy they arrested was the unlucky sap dating her, Larry Butts. Oh man, it is Butts. Yes, my best friend since grade school. Our school had a saying, when something smells, it's usually the Butts. Oh. I mean, Butts do smell. Wow. Narfibu, hello! Oh man, those emotes are adorable. Oh, it's so cute. Dinosaur? Oh man, I'm writing that down. I love me some Pokemon emotes. Is it bad that I just sub to people just for emotes? It's like Fifi. I just like the Fifi dragons. But hi, Narfy. Welcome. Thanks for stopping by. Appreciate it. We're playing Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney, the trilogy on the Switch. I have never played before. This was recommended and requested by a friend of mine. And yeah, so some fun stuff. And a goose! What? Goose stab! Oh my god, I love it. So good. Also writing that down. Gonna make me run out of money, Narfy. Killing me. I love it. In the 23 years I've known him, it's usually been true. I do every month. He has a knack for getting himself in trouble. One thing I can say though, it's usually not his fault. He just has terrible luck. But I know better than anyone that he's a good guy at heart. That, and I owe him one, which is why I took the case to clear his name. That's just what I'm gonna do. Well, I mean, I know, and you know, that it wasn't him. It was a setup, so that's kind of interesting that they give you that meta knowledge. August 3rd, 10 a.m. District Court number 2. Oh. Court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Larry Butts. The prosecution is ready, Your Honor. Oh man, look at his hair. His hair is so good. The defense is ready, Your Honor. Mr. Wright. This is your first trial, is it not? Yes, Your Honor. I'm a little nervous. Your conduct during this trial will decide the fate of your client. Murder is a serious charge. For your client's sake, I hope you can control your nerves. Thank you, Your Honor. What is. Hold on. I have an options button. Oh, I can just save. I mean, that's good. Day one trial, Phoenix Wright. Oh, okay. All right. And what is this? Attorney's badge. No one would believe I was a defense attorney if I didn't carry it. Loss of blood due to blunt trauma. Oh, this is like evidence. Okay. Oh, and there's profiles. Cindy Stone, the victim in this case, a model, she lived in an apartment by herself. Prosecutor for the case lacks patience, generally bad at getting his points across. Lol. Okay. Hosted the stream! Oh, well, thanks for the host, Narfy! I appreciate it! Much love. I need to make sure the alert box is in a proper spot. I didn't even hear it go off. What the heck, Streamlabs? What we doing here? Who is my boss? Oh, the lady from earlier? Yeah, Mia. My boss and very good attorney. The waifu? I know, that's what I thought when I saw her. I didn't want to say anything. She is the weefoo. Oh, man. Oh, well, okay. I guess alerts are down. Whatever. Whatever. It's fine. No, it's fine, Streamlabs. I didn't. Oh. Oh, there we go. Okay, whatever. Whatever, it's fine. Okay, I fixed it though, so that's good. Yeah, man. Waifu is boss. Alright, Mr. Wright, given the circumstances, I think we should have a test to ascertain your readiness. Oh, well, that's nice. Yes, Your Honor. Gulp, hands shaking, eyesight fading. What? This test will consist of a few simple questions. Answer them clearly and concisely. Please state the name of the defendant in this case. Oh, Larry Butts. Defendant? Well, that's Larry Butts, Your Honor. Correct. Just keep your wits about you and you'll do fine. Next question. I like the dude's beard, by the way. This is a murder trial. Tell me what's the victim's name. Whew, I know this one. Glad I read the case report cover to cover so many times. It's... wait. Uh-oh. No. No way. I forgot. I'm drawing a total blank here. Phoenix, are you absolutely sure you're up for this? Oh, man. Waifu. you don't even know the victim's name? Oh, the victim. Of course I know the victim's name. I, just forgot. Temporarily. I think I feel a migraine coming on. Look, the victim's name is listed in the court record. Just press the R button to check it at any time, okay? Oh, you can check it at any time? Oh, I feel like that's an easy mode thing. I assume this gets harder as we go. Maybe not. Maybe that's not the point of this. I don't know the point of this game. Is it the point just to have... I don't know. Remember to check it often. Do it for me, please. I'm begging you. Yes, Daddy. Mr. Wright, who is the victim in this case? Well, we already checked. It was, Cindy Stone. Cinderblock. Yes, it's one of these games. The victim's name is Cindy Stone. Correct. Now, tell me, what was the cause of death? She died because she was hit with a blunt object. We saw that in the beginning. I do enjoy this music, though. Let me know if the music's too loud. I had to turn it down a lot, but... She was struck once by a blunt object. Correct. You've answered all my questions. I see no reason why we shouldn't proceed. You seem much more relaxed, Mr. Wright. Good for you. Thank you, Your Honor. Because I don't feel relaxed, that's for sure. Oh, animus. Well then, first, a question for the prosecution, Mr. Payne. Yes, Your Honor. As Mr. Wright just told us, the victim was struck with a blunt object. Would you explain to the court just what the object was? The murder weapon was the statue of the Thinker. It was found lying on the floor next to the victim. I see. The court accepts it into evidence. Statue added to the court record. A statue in the shape of the Thinker. It's rather heavy. Right. Be sure to pay attention to any evidence added during the trial. That evidence is the only ammunition you have in court. Use the R button to check the court record frequently. Mr. Payne, the prosecution may call its first witness. The prosecution calls the defendant, Mr. Butts, to the stand. Chief, what do I do now? Oh, come on, Phoenix. Pay attention. You don't want to miss any information that might help your client's case. You'll get your chance to respond to the prosecution later, so be ready. Let's just hope he doesn't say anything unfortunate. Uh-oh. Larry gets excited easily. This could be bad. Oh, dear. That smug face. Mr. Butts, is it not true that the victim has recently dumped you? Hey, watch it, buddy. We were great together. We were Romeo and Juliet, Cleopatra and Mark Anthony. Didn't they all die? I wasn't dumped. She just wasn't taking my phone calls or seeing me. Ever. What's to you, anyway? Yikes. Yikes, bro. Mr. Butts, what you describe is generally what we mean by dumped. In fact, she had completely abandoned you and was seeing other men. She had just returned from overseas with one of them the day before the murder. What do you mean, one of them? Lies! All of it lies! I don't believe a word of it! Your Honor, the victim's passport. According to this, she was in Paris until the day before she died. Passport added to... Victim apparently arrived home at 7:30 the day before the murder. Okay. Indeed, she appears to have returned the day before the murder. Dude, no way. The victim was a model, but did not have a large income. It appears that she had several sugar daddies. Oh, what? Excuse me? Daddies? Sugar? Oh my god, yes. Older men who gave her money and gifts. She took their money and used it to support her lifestyle. Dude! We can clearly see what kind of woman this Miss Stone was. Tell me, Mr. Butts, what do you think of her now? Rude? I don't think you want him to answer that question. Yeah, Larry has a way of running his mouth in all the wrong directions. Should I... Objection! My client had no idea the victim was seeing other men. That question is irrelevant to this case. Oof. Dude, Nick, what do you mean irrelevant? That cheating she-dog! She-dog! Wow, dude. I'm gonna die. I'm just gonna drop dead. Yeah, and when I meet her in the afterlife, I'm gonna get to the bottom of this. Let's continue with the trial, shall we? I believe the accused's motive is clear to everyone. Yes, quite. Oh boy, this is so not looking good. Next question. You went to the victim's apartment on the day of the murder, did you not? Gulp. Well, did you or did you not? Hehe, well, maybe I did and maybe I didn't. Oh no. Have him answer honestly, because that's, he can't lie in court. Lying in court is bad. She wasn't home, man, so, like, I didn't see her. Your Honor, the defendant is lying. Lying? The prosecution would like to call a witness who can prove Mr. Butts is lying. Well, that simplifies matters. Who is your witness? The man who found the victim's body. Just before making the gruesome discovery, he saw the defendant fleeing the scene of the crime. Order! Order in the court! Mr. Payne, the prosecution may call its witness. Yes, Your Honor. This is bad. On the day of the murder, my witness was selling newspapers at the victim's building. Please bring Mr. Frank Sawit to the stand. It's the guy that did it! Mr. Sawit, you sell newspaper subscriptions, is that correct? Oh yes, newspapers, yes. Mr. Sawit, you may proceed with your testimony. Please tell the court what you saw on the day of the murder. I was going door to door selling subscriptions when I saw a man fleeing an apartment. I thought he must be in a hurry because he left the door half open behind him. Thinking it strange, I looked inside the apartment. Then, I saw her lying there, a woman, not moving. Dead! I quailed in fright and found myself unable to go inside. Is that quailed? Quailed? I don't know. There's a lot of hard words here, I just want you guys to know. I thought to call the police immediately. However, the phone in her apartment wasn't working. I went to a nearby park and found a public phone. I remember the time exactly. It was 1 p.m. The man who ran was, without a doubt, the defendant sitting right over there. Why are you lying, bro? Larry, why didn't you tell the truth? I can't defend you against a testimony like that. Incidentally, why wasn't the phone in the victim's apartment working? Your Honor, at the time of the murder, there was a blackout in the building. Aren't phones supposed to work during a blackout? Yes, Your Honor. However, some cordless phones do not function normally. The phone that Mr. Sawit used was one of those. Your Honor? I have a record of the blackout for your perusal. Electricity to Mrs. Stone's building was out from noon to 6 on the day of the crime. Now, Mr. Wright, yes, Your Honor. You may bring your cross-examination. Cross-examination, Your Honor? Alright, Wright, this is it. The real deal. What exactly am I supposed to do? Come on, Phoenix! Why? You exposed the lies in the testimony the witness just gave. Lies? What? He was lying? Your client is innocent, right? Then that witness must have lied in his testimony. Or is your client really guilty? How do I prove he's not? You hold the key. It's in the evidence. Compare the witness's testimony to the evidence at hand. I think it's something with the time. There's bound to be a contradiction in there. First, find the contradictions between the court record and the witness's testimony. Then, once you've found the contradicting evidence, present it and rub it in the witness's face. Oh man, I hope he stands up and like does this. That would be so silly. Okay. Open the court record with the R button and then point out contradictions in the testimony. Cross-examination. Witness accounts. I was going door-to-door selling subscriptions when I saw a man fleeing his apartment. Press. Present. Yeah, 4 to 5. Time of death. What's press? I find it odd you would take notice of him. I don't know, he just seems strange to me, that's all. Like, he was mad and yet frightened at the same time. Just like a criminal fleeing the scene of a crime. Defense requests the witness refrain from conjecture. Of course, what the witness means is that the man he saw looks suspicious. So what happened next? I thought he must be in a hurry because he left the door half open behind him. Thinking it strange, I looked inside the apartment. Then I saw her laying there, a woman, not moving, dead. I quailed in fright and found myself unable to go inside. I thought to call the police immediately. However, the phone in her apartment wasn't working. But he didn't go inside. The phone in her apartment wasn't working. Yes, I mean, no, it wasn't, right? But you said you didn't go into the apartment. Or did you? Ha ha! Oh, that, I can explain that. There was a cordless phone on a shelf in the entranceway. I reached inside and tried to use that to call. That phone wasn't working, correct? What happened next? I went to a nearby park and found a public phone. I remember the time exactly. It was 1 p.m. Present. Objection. You found the body at 1 p.m., you're sure? Yes, it was 1 p.m. for certain. Frankly, I find that hard to believe! Your statement directly contradicts the autopsy report. The autopsy notes the time of death at some time after 4 p.m. There was no body to find at 1 p.m. How do you explain this 3-hour gap? Ha ha ha, yes, feels good. This is trivial. The witness merely forgot the time. After his testimony, I find that hard to believe. Mr. Sawit, why were you so certain that you found the body at 1 p.m.? That's a really good question. Great job, Wright. Way to put him on the spot. That's all you have to do. Point out contradictions. Lies always beget more lies. See through one and their whole story falls apart. Cool. Wait, I remember now. Would you care to give your testimony again? You see, when I found the body, I heard the time. There was a voice saying the time. It was probably coming from the television. Oh, but it was 3 hours off, wasn't it? I guess the victim must have been watching a video of a taped program. That's why I thought it was 1 p.m. Terribly sorry about the misunderstanding. I see. You heard a voice saying the time on a taped program. Mr. Wright, you may cross-examine the witness. Wright, you know what to do. I've got this one. Yeah, the blackout. There was a voice saying the time. It was probably coming from the television. Objection! Hold it right there. The prosecution has said there was a blackout at the time of discovery. And this record proves it. You couldn't have heard a television or a video. Gah! The defense has a point. Do you have an explanation for this, Mr. Sawit? No, I find it quite puzzling myself. Quite. Ah, wait, I remember now. Mr. Sawit, the court would prefer to hear an accurate testimony from the very beginning. This is very interesting. The constant corrections are harming your credibility. That, and you seem rather distraught. My apologies, Your Honor. It must have been the shock of finding the body. Very well, Mr. Sawit. Let's hear your testimony once more, please. Oh, man. Actually, I didn't hear the time. I saw it. There was a table clock in the apartment, wasn't there? Yeah, the murder weapon. The killer used it to hit the victim. That must have been what I saw. You saw a clock? I guess that would explain it. The defense may cross-examine the witness. Gladly. Actually, I didn't hear the time. I saw it. Strikes me as a very suspicious mistake. Yes, I can see how you'd be a little doubtful. I'm really sorry. I only just remember the table clock. Table clock? There was a table clock in the apartment, wasn't there? Yeah, the murder weapon. The killer used it to hit the victim. Oh, silly goose. Present! Objection! Wait just a moment. The murder weapon wasn't a clock. It was the statue. Now, how is this supposed to be a clock? What? You with your objections and your evidence. Just who do you think you are? Just answer the question, Mr. Sawit. Hey, I saw it there, okay? That's a clock. Your Honor, if I may. Yes, Mr. Payne? As the witness stated, this statue is indeed a clock. The neck is a switch. You just tilt it, and it says the time out loud. As it doesn't look like a clock, I submitted it as a statue. My apologies. I see. So, the murder weapon was a table clock after all. Well, Mr. Wright, it appears that the witness's testimony was correct. This is a clock. Do you have any problems with his testimony now? Yes. Your Honor, there is a gaping hole in the witness's testimony. The only way he could have known the weapon was a clock is to hold it in his hands. Yet, the witness testified that he never entered the apartment. It's clearly a contradiction. Indeed. The witness knew it was a clock because he went into the apartment. You're lying. You were inside the apartment on the day of the murder. Oh yeah? Prove it. Prove it I went in there. I'll do better than that. I can prove you were the one who killed her. You struck her with the clock, and the shock of the blow triggered the clock's voice. That was the sound you heard. Order in the court. Intriguing. Please continue, Mr. Wright. Yes, Your Honor. Mr. Sawit, the sound must have left quite an impression on you. Understandable, since the murder weapon spoke just as you hit the victim. That voice was burned into your mind. That's why you were so certain about the time. What's the meaning of this? This is all baseless conjecture. Baseless? Just look at the witness's face! Would the witness care to elaborate? Did you strike the victim with the clock? I never... Look, the clock. I heard no, I mean, I saw... Gross.
What?
Shut up! I hate you! It was him, I tell you! I saw him! He killed her, and he should burn. Burn! Give him death! Order in the court, I say. Your Honor, a moment, please. There isn't a shred of evidence supporting the defense's claims. Mr. Wright! Your Honor, you claim the sound the witness heard came from the clock. Do you have any evidence? The whole case is riding on this. I better think it through carefully. Your Honor, the sound Mr. Schwab heard was definitely this clock. A fact which is clear if you simply...
Try sounding the clock.
Let's sound the clock now, here in this court. Your Honor, may I have the clock? I ask the court to listen very carefully. I think it's 8:25. That certainly is a strange way to announce the time. Well, he is the thinker, after all. So, we've heard the clock. What are your conclusions, Mr. Wright? Mr. Payne, can you tell me what time it is now? It's 11:25. Ugh! As you can see, this clock is exactly 3 hours slow. Precisely the discrepancy between what Mr. Sawit heard and the actual time of death. So, Mr. Sawit, try to talk your way out of this one. Ha! You forgot one thing. Uh-oh, what's he talking about now? While it may seem like the clock is running 3 hours slow, it proves nothing. How do you know it was running 3 hours slow on the day of the murder? You can't prove that. You don't have a case. He's right.
How am I going to prove that? Damn it! I was so close.
Mr. Wright, seems you lack the critical evidence to support your claim. Yes, Your Honor. This means I cannot let you indict the witness. Unfortunately, this ends the cross-examination of Mr. Frank Sawit. Came all the way down here to testify, and look what happens. You treat me like a criminal. A criminal! You lawyers are all slime. Oh.
What? Oh, the boss! The waifu is coming in hot! Not so fast, Mr. Sawit. I mean, Chief! Listen up, Wright. Don't throw this one away. Not like this. Think. But Chief, it's over. I can't prove the clock was slow the day of the murder. Nobody can prove that. Well, yes. But that doesn't mean you can't still win. Try thinking out of the box. Don't waste time doubting the facts. Assume the clock was 3 hours slow and think through it. Ask yourself, why was the clock 3 hours slow? Figure out the reason and you'll have your proof. Right? Right? Can you think of a reason as to why this clock would be 3 hours slow? Power went out, batteries are dead. She was traveling. Wait! Maybe I can prove it. You must have evidence somewhere that can prove it, right? Find it and let them have it. Well, Mr. Wright, you say the clock was already running slow on the day of the murder. Have you found evidence to support this claim? Of course. There's a piece of evidence in the court record that can prove my claim beyond a doubt. Ha! Tough words. Let's see you pull this one off. Let's see the evidence that proves why the clock was running slow. I don't know, actually. Is it the electricity again? I mean, I haven't used the passport, but it could be. Something about time zones, you think so? Oh, maybe she brought the clock with. Is the thinker in Paris? The victim had just returned home from abroad the day before the murder. As we all know, the time difference between here and Paris is 9 hours. Oh, wow, you're so smart, Athena! I didn't even think about that. What? When it's 4 p.m. here, it's 1 a.m. the next day there. Oh, the clock wasn't 3 hours slow. It was 9 hours fast. The victim hadn't reset her clock since returning home. That's why the time you heard when you struck her dead in the apartment was wrong. Proof enough for you, Mr. Sawit, or should I say, Mr. Did It? Yeah. What? Did you just have a heart attack? Order, I say.
What happened? Well, this case has certainly turned out differently than we all expected. Mr. Payne, your witness? He was arrested and has been taken away, Your Honor. Saw it and did it. That was pretty good.
It's funny.
This is a silly game. I like it. It's got, like, all these hidden, like, sillinesses. Very well, Mr. Wright. Yes, Your Honor. I have to say, I'm impressed. I don't think I've ever seen someone complete a defense so quickly and find the true culprit at the same time. Thank you, Your Honor. At this point, this is only a formality, but this court finds the defendant, Mr. Larry Butts, not guilty. Hard to believe we're talking about little murder, I know, right? And with that, this court is adjourned. Wait, was there just confetti? Wait a minute, what? Turns out that Frank Sawit was a common burglar. He posed as a newspaper salesman to check and see when people were out of the house. That day... Confetti, what the heck? When Larry went to her apartment, the victim wasn't home. After he left, Mr. Sawit let himself in to do his dirty work. While he was searching her place, the victim returned. Flustered, Miss Sawit grabbed the nearest blunt object he could find. August 3rd, 2:32 p.m., District Court, Defendant Lobby Number 2. Phew, still can't believe we won! Right, good job in there. Congratulations. Thanks, waifu. Thanks, chief. I owe it all to you. Not at all, not at all. You fought your own battles in there. It's been a while since I've seen a trial end on such a satisfying note. I've never seen the chief looking this happy. If she's this glad, imagine how Larry must feel. My life is over. Larry! You're supposed to be happy. What's wrong now? Aw, Nick. Don't worry about me. I'll be dead and gone soon. Good. Wait. No, I mean, bad. Bad, bad, bad. Larry, you're innocent. The case is closed. But my Cindy Windy's gone, man. Gone forever. Larry, she was a... Nah, never mind. Congratulations, Harry. Harry? Yes, you can practically see the headlines now. Harry Butts, innocent. Wait a minute. Isn't his name Larry? Harry Butts. thanks. I really owe you one. I won't forget this, ever. Let's celebrate. Dinner? Movie? My treat. Oh no, I couldn't. Hey, I was the one who got you off the hook. Oh, hey. Here, take this. It's a present. A present? For me? Wait, wasn't this the evidence that... Actually, I made this clock for her. I made one for her and one for me. Really? You made this? Well, thank you. I'll keep it as a memento. Harry Butts. Yo, Nick, can you believe it? I was so into that chick, and she was just playing me for a fool. Don't that make you want to just cry? Larry. Are you so sure? Excuse me? Oh my god. I think she thought quite a lot of you in her own way. Nah, you don't gotta sympathize with me. It's okay. Oh, I'm not just sympathizing. Really? Isn't that right? Right. Don't you have something to show your friend? Something that proves how she felt about him? Huh? Oh yeah, right. What the heck is she talking about? Uh... the other statue. What? I'm so confused. Check this out, Larry. Proof positive you weren't just some chump to her. Huh? What about that clock? This is the clock you made for her, Larry. And she took it with her when she traveled. Whatever, she probably just needed a clock, that's all. You think so? It's a pretty heavy clock to take traveling. Well, make of it what you will. Hey, Nick, I'm glad I asked you to be my lawyer. Really, I am. Thanks. Sparkly eyes. Hope that made him feel a little better. Wow, dude. What a game. It's something different, that's for sure. Right, I hope you see the importance of evidence now. Also, hopefully you realize things change depending on how you look at them. People, too. We never really know if our clients are guilty or innocent. All we can do is believe in them. And in order to believe in them, you have to believe in yourself. Right? Listen. Learn. Grow strong. Never let go of what you believe in. Never. Alright, waifu. Well, I think our work here is done. Shall we be off? Yeah, I guess so. Say, how about dinner? On me. Ooh! We'll drink a toast to innocent butts. Why? Yeah. Oh, speaking of Harry, you were saying part of why you became a lawyer was because of him. Yeah, part at least. You'll have to tell me more about it sometime. Maybe over drinks. Ooh. Alright, boss. And so my first trial came to a close. Larry slapped me on the back and said, gee, Nick, it's good to have friends. But I'm pretty sure he's not going to pay us, unless you count the clock he gave Mia. I didn't know it then, but that clock was soon going to be at the center of another incident. And my promise to tell the chief about me and Larry would be one promise that I wouldn't be able to keep. Oh no! What does that mean?! Not the chief! Not the chief! What? Don't do this to me. Brand new episode has been added. Save your progress? Yes. Not the chief, man. Episode 2, Turnabout Sisters. Man, what the hell type foreshadowing was that? I swear, dude. Oh, no. Hello, this is Maya. Hey, Maya, it's me. Mia, what's up? You haven't called in a while. Sorry, I've been so busy. How have you been? Well, lonely, and it's all your fault. Nah, I'm just teasing. I've been great. I'm finally getting used to having my own place. That's good to hear. Actually, I'm calling because I have a favor to ask. I know, you want me to hold evidence for you. Sharp as always. There's a lot of buzz about the upcoming trial. I just don't feel safe keeping the evidence here. I gotcha. So, what is it this time? It's a clock. A clock? Yeah, it's made to look like the statue, the thinker, and it tells you the time. I thought you might like it. You always liked toys. Hey, I'm not a little girl anymore, sis. Now, you know I'm only teasing. Ah, I should probably tell you, the clock isn't talking right now. Huh? It's not working. That's lame. I had to take the clockwork out. Sorry. I put some papers inside it instead. Papers? Is that the evidence then? Well, there's a possibility that it might turn out that way, yes. Can you come by the office tonight, say 9, to pick it up? I'll be in, pre-trial meeting until then. Okay, sis, but I expect dinner, something good, like burgers. I could really go for a good burger. Okay, okay. We'll hit the usual joint. Alright, it's a deal. Okay, sis, see you soon. Yep, I'll be waiting, Maya. Ow. Conversation recorded, September 5th, 9:27 a.m. Oh no, something's gonna happen to the chief. September 5th, 8:57, Faye and Co. Law Offices. Now, Miss Faye, I'll take what's mine, the papers. I'm sorry, but I can't give you what I don't have. Miss Faye, you are a poor liar. Why? I see it right over there. That must be the thinker that swallowed those papers. How could you know? Ho ho, you are not coniferous on my background? Whatever. Gathering information is my business, you see. I should have been more careful. Ho ho! My dear Miss Fay, I am so very sorry, but I am afraid I must ask you for one more thing. Your eternal silence. Farewell, Miss Fay. Oh no! The waifu! Red, white, blue. September 5th, 9:08 p.m. Faye and Co. Law Offices. Uh-oh, I'm late. That's strange. Guess the chief left without me. She said her sister was coming over, so we should all go out for dinner. What's that smell? Blood? Mia! Maybe she's in her office. That smell. Blood! Sis. Someone's there. Chief? Chief? Chief! Rip. Who are you? That strange girl dropped out cold. I left her lying on the office sofa. I went back to the chief where she lay under the window. Body was still warm. I could feel it when I held her shoulder. Then, all too quickly, it began to fade. Until finally, she was cold. Oh no, the chief! Chief! Crusted with dried blood. How ironic that this became the murder weapon. Again. Chief. It's hard seeing her like this, but if there are any clues here, she was struck on the head with a blunt object. She probably died instantly. The thinker lying next to her must have been a murder weapon. There are some glass shards near the chief's body. Must be pieces of the glass light stand laying broken in the back of the room. Piece of paper. Must have fallen from Mia's hand. What could it be? A word is written in blood and on the scrap of paper. Maya, did Mia write this? This piece of paper is a receipt from a department store dated yesterday. I think that's enough snooping around for now. I'd better call the police and find out what that girl is doing here. I'm just investigating things. Okay. That's funny. A few of the screws on the receiver are missing. It looks like someone was halfway through taking it apart. Police! Please come quick. What was that? Someone screamed from outside the window? She's staring right at me. She's holding a phone in her hand. Just now. Where'd she go? I put her right there on the sofa. Uh-oh. I hope she didn't run on me. Yipes! Don't scare me like that. Excuse me, but who are you? It's okay. I work here. Maya. Maya Faye. Maya Faye? Maya. So Mia was writing this girl's name. Maybe I should show her the receipt? I never thought there'd be a use for evidence like this outside the courtroom. I don't know if you should show her the receipt. But, Ken... She wrote a message with her own blood. She wrote it on the back of this receipt. That's my name! Why? Why would she write my name? Please, just calm down. Why would Sis write my name? Uh-oh. Now I've done it. Wee-woo, wee-woo, wee-woo. The police! Sounds like they're coming this way. Freeze! Police! Alright, I'm Detective Dick Gumshoe. See? Gumshoe? What an odd name. Received a report from the building across the way, see? Got a person saying they saw a murder. Must have been that woman I saw. Anyway, I don't want either of you moving one inch, okay? Great. Just great. Maya, wait. She couldn't have... Nah. Whoa! Excuse me. Eek? This word Maya here mean anything to you? That's my name. What? The victim drew this here note in her own blood, see? With her dying breath, she wrote down the killer's name. killer. I'm not. Case closed. You're coming down to the precinct, ma'am. What? Oh, dear. Mia's young sister, Maya, was arrested on the spot. I was taken in for questioning and didn't get out until the next morning. One second. Well, that's unfortunate. My eyes were heavy, but I couldn't sleep. I sat around, waiting for the visiting hours to begin at the detention center. I had to talk to Maya as soon as possible. September 6th, 9:07 a.m., detention center, visitor's room. Wow, they have poor Maya locked up like a criminal. Oh, it's you, the lawyer. Good morning. Good morning. She looks so tired. Are you going to be my attorney? Well, that's what I wanted to talk to you about. First things first, I better get her cheered up. Yeah, of course I will. Cheer up. Really? Whoa, did I say the wrong thing? She looks sadder now. What's wrong? You don't think I can do it? No one could. Who could believe me? Even you, when you found me in the office, you looked at me like I had done it. Did I look at her like that? No, I never thought. It's okay, I understand. And I've also heard about you. Heard what about me? I was talking to my sister on the phone the other day. Today was my junior partner's first time in court. Wow, really? How'd that go? It was quite the scene. Honestly, I was on the edge the whole time. It's been a while. Ha! So he crashed and burned. He's a genius. One of those strike fear into the hearts of evil types. The only thing he's lacking is experience. Huh? Sounds like it was fun. Well, I know who to go to if I ever get in trouble now. I don't know, Maya. I think you might want to wait. Give him 3 more years. That is, unless you want to be found guilty. Wow, rude. That's what she said. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to insult you. No, it's okay. It's true, I guess. But at the same time, I can't just sit by and watch. When I think of the person who did this to Mia, I know. There's something I've been wanting to ask you. Yes? What's with the outfit? Oh, this? This is what all acolytes wear. It's my uniform, you could say. Acolytes? Like people in religious training? What is it you do? Oh, it's nothing strange, really. I'm a spirit medium in training. A spirit medium? Pretty sure that qualifies as strange. Interesting. Could you tell me about the day of the murder? Yes. Let's see. That morning, I got a call from my sister. She wanted me to hold on to a piece of evidence for an upcoming trial. Evidence? Yes. That clock shaped like the Thinker. The one Larry made. How could that have been evidence in a case? Right. She said something about that. I remember. Do you want to hear it in her own voice? Hear her own voice? Yes. I'm pretty sure our conversation is on my cell phone. You recorded it? Yeah. I forgot how to delete these things. So, you say you have a conversation with your sister on your cell phone. Let's hear it. Right. Oh. I just remembered. That detective took my cell phone. Sorry. Oh, right. Of course. Next time I see Detective Gumshoe, I'll ask him for it. I'll write you a note so you don't forget. Okay? Sure. Thanks. So you're an acolyte, medium in training. That's right. The Fae family, especially the women, have always been very sensitive to the spirit world. Wait a second, you said the Fae family? So, Mia was into this stuff too? Of course. She left the mountain to follow her career, she said. Her powers were first class, too.
I had no idea.
Wait. What? So, you're a real, honest-to-goodness spirit medium, with ESP and all that?
Yes, in training.
Well, can you contact Mia's spirit, then? We can just ask her who killed her.
I'm sorry. I'm still in training. I couldn't do something on that level.
I thought that would be too easy.
Huh? Something the matter?
I was wondering, could I ask you a favor?
This is the address of a famous lawyer. My sister gave me this a long time ago. She said if I was ever in trouble, I should call him. And, well, I'm in trouble. Do you think you could go ask him to represent me?
Sure, why not? I'll go ask. Thank you so much! I have no one else to turn to. Say, what about your parents?
I see. Don't worry. Leave it to me. Thank you. Trial's tomorrow at 10.
What? Tomorrow?
Tomorrow.
What if this guy refuses?
They told me that if I don't find one, the state will pick an attorney to defend me.
When will that happen?
They're giving me until 4 this afternoon. Visiting hours are almost up. I'd better hurry.
Right. I'll be back.
All I've been doing the last few hours is talking about it. I've kind of gotten used to it. Let's see. That morning... Oh yeah, she got a call. She arrived in the office right around 9. The lights were off and I could smell blood. Then I found her, my sister.
Thanks. That's all I need to hear for now.
According to the receptionist, the big boss is out. She couldn't say when he'd be back. It must be hard to keep track of everything when you're a famous lawyer. Not to mention run an office like this. Guess I'll just have to come back later. That painting has been bugging me ever since I stepped in here. The oil paint is so thick it's practically giving me a stuffed nose. I'm sure the price is nothing to sneeze at either, for that matter. Alright, we're just gonna look around here. Solid gold! Wow!
Hey, you there! This is a crime scene, pal! No trespassing!
Sorry. Don't I know you from somewhere? Wait, you're the Butts guy, aren't you?
No. Phoenix Wright. How can anyone mistake me for Larry?
Ah, I guess I got the name wrong, Mr. Wright. Sorry about that. That Butts guy, he was a killer, and you're no killer, right?
He was proven innocent. Right. And you were...
Detective Gumshoe.
Gumshoe, wasn't it? Dick Gumshoe?
Right, at your service. Hang on, that's Detective Gumshoe to you, pal. Anyway, get the name right.
Don't call me Dick.
Hey, Dick, get over here.
Yes, sir, be right there.
You're her lawyer, right, pal? If you got business here, you better do it quick.
Whew, he thinks I'm, Maya's lawyer. I was wondering, did you see Maya Faye's cell phone? Oh, that? I have that. Do you think you could give it back? Sure. I mean, wait a second, pal. Tricky lawyer. Uh-oh, he's on to me. If I tell him why I want it, there's no way he'll give it to me. Something the matter? Oh, no. It's just, you know, detective. Nope, I know nothing, pal. That cell phone has a lot of numbers on it, like her boyfriend's. A cell phone holds a little girl's sweet and spaciest secrets. You're trying to confuse me. Sorry, pal. Ari checked all the numbers in memory. Impressive, you're quite the detective. Oh, here. You can have the phone back. There weren't any suspicious call records in there, after all. Seems you didn't notice the recorded conversation. My cell phone received from Detective Gumshoe. Check the courtroom to hear the recorded conversation. Which we've already talked about earlier. About Miss Faye, did you do an autopsy? You want to know the results, eh? Now don't you look at me like that, pal. It's no use. She might have been your boss, but that doesn't mean you get any special treatment. Alright, you can see the report, but that's all. 9 p.m., single blunt force trauma, death was instantaneous. Yeah, I'm looking forward to the trial. Sorry, pal, but this is one trial you aren't going to win. Why do you say that? The city's put Prosecutor Edgeworth on the prosecution. Edgeworth? I'm sure you know what that means, you being a lawyer and all. I guess I've asked all the questions I need to. Are you done, pal? Yes, thank you. I'll be heading out now. Oh, wait, one more thing I wanted to mention to you. Don't suppose you're planning on talking to the witness. Anyway, you better not. No influencing the witness with your lawyerly ways, pal. Come to think of it, I had completely forgotten about her. The witness? Yeah, Miss April May. Sorry about this, but I can't tell you anything about her. Well, you just told me her name, Miss May, huh? So you've sent her home already then? Aha, you're trying your lawyerly tricks on me now. She's not to go outside her room until the trial. So, she's still in her hotel across the way. I guess I should know better than to try to get a detective to leak information. You got that right, pal. Time to pay a visit to Miss May. Prosecutor Edgeworth. That's right, pal. Mr. Miles Edgeworth himself. Wait, you don't know him? Wait, you do know him, don't you? Of course I do. I know him. He's a feared prosecutor. He doesn't feel pain. He doesn't feel remorse. He won't stop until he gets his guilty verdict. Aw, don't talk about him that way. You make him barely sound human. Still, I'm afraid this pretty much decides the case. So, Edgeworth is on this one. He hasn't lost a case since he became prosecutor at the incredibly young age of 20. Of course, there are rumors of back alley deals and forged evidence. All I know for sure is that Edgeworth hates crime with an almost abnormal passion. I never imagined I'd be facing him so soon. Well, hello there, handsome. Hi. Smooth, right? Real smooth. You're the lawyer, aren't you? The detective told me about. He said, don't say nothing to that lawyer, pal. Teehee. Memo to self. Thank Detective Gumshoe for making my job harder. Gee, this is all like something out of a movie. It's all so exciting, I can hardly contain myself. Ooh, let me go freshen up so I can look the part of the beautiful eyewitness. I pity the lawyer that has to cross-examine this one. Oh, God. There's a screwdriver stuck in this drawer. I wonder what's inside. Let's take a look. Hey! Hey! What are you doing? No touching! Oh, bad boy. You really shouldn't pry around in other people's rooms now. You wouldn't want to make me upset, would you? Upset? I thought she was going to explode for a second there. I wonder what could be inside the drawer. Late summer sunlight streams through the window. There's the fan co across the... You can see the inside of the room pretty clearly from here. I think it would have been a little difficult to recognize a face from this distance, though. The flowers are fake, as expected. Alright, searching around the room... Something with the screwdriver. Okay. Ooh, delivery service. Oh man, the best delivery service. Oh, that was adorable. Good old baby fish. Okay. Do you think you could tell me something? I need you to describe what you observed at the time of the incident. Oh, observe? Incident? You sound just like a lawyer in the movies. I like a man with a big vocabulary. Oh my god, please stop. Better not encourage her. You know that thing that happened the other day? The bad thing? What did you see when it happened? I don't suppose you could tell me about it, pretty please? Let me see, well, dream on. If you want to know, you'll just have to come to court tomorrow, Mr. Lawyer. Oh, boy. could you just exactly... Who are you? Oh, Mr. Lawyer, are you hitting on me? Oh, my God. What is happening? I'm just doing my job here. You know, you're cute when you blush. Believe me, this is the first time in my life I've blushed this much. Right, can you just tell me what it is you do? Well, no, teehee, and you had your little hopes up, didn't you? Jesus Christ, I see there are two glasses on the table. Is someone staying here with you? Oh, what an amazing powers of observation. You must be one of those famous detectives, like a television. Oh no, not me. I'm just a lawyer. Say, Mr. Big Detective, why don't you go look for clues in the garbage, hmm? Miss May doesn't like nosy little lawyers, humph. Yikes. I want the screwdriver. Man. And I don't think I can present anything to her. Okay, let's go back to the detention center. Hi. What is it? Did you meet the lawyer? Sorry. I haven't seen him yet. I see. I better go see if I can find this elite lawyer she's talking about. Hey, I got your cell phone back. Oh, say, can I listen to my sister's voice? Maya's eyes closed. She listened to every word with such intensity. Before long, tears began to roll down her cheeks. Thank you. What about your family? I only had my sister. My father died when I was very young, and I don't know where my mother is. Don't know? So she could still be alive. The woman in my family have been mediums for generations. They say a lot of spiritual power runs in our blood. About 15 years ago, Our family was involved in an incident. There was a man, and he ruined our mother's life. Ruined? After that, she disappeared. Several years after that, my sister announced she would become a lawyer, and she left the mountain. So, you live by yourself? Yes. I've gotten used to it. Oh, also, I had to become independent or I would lose my powers. I feel bad for her. All by herself up on the mountain? So, who was this man, who ruined your mother? About 15 years ago, there was an unusual murder case. It made quite a stir. Everyone was talking about it, apparently. The police were running out of leads, and they were getting desperate. Wait, they didn't use a spirit medium, did they? The police convinced my mother to try and contact the victim. Wow, so what happened? The case was solved, we thought. You thought? The man my mother helped the police capture was innocent. The police's consultation with the medium had all been carried out in secret, of course. But the man found out about it and leaked it to the press. He told all the papers that my mother was a fraud, and the media jumped on it big time. She, my mother, became the laughingstock of the nation. I see. White. Excuse me? White? That was his name, my sister told me. White? That wasn't the most over-the-top clearing of the throat I ever heard. Aha! So, you're the one they say has been looking for me. Yes, that's me. He looks even grander than I imagined. That badge on your collar. Ah, so you're a lawyer, are you now? Yes, well, yes. And what do you want? I'm not particularly busy these days. Please, proceed. Not busy? Then how come no one could get in touch with you? Something the matter? You came to see the one and only Marvin Grossberg, did you not? Well, here I am, boy. What do you want? Out with it. Well, sir, actually, it's about Maya Fae. Ah, yes, Maya Fae. Go on. I had a strange reaction. I'm really quite busy here, son. I can't go taking cases on a day's notice. No, it's quite impossible. Well, wait a second. How do you know the trial was tomorrow? anyway. I'm afraid it's entirely impossible for me to represent her. Sorry. End of discussion. What's going on? He refused me before I even got a chance to ask him. What do I tell Maya? Okay, I already examined his room. Hold on. He said he wasn't busy. Wait a second. How can you just refuse like that? Please tell me why you won't take the case. Well, you see, it's just I'm busy, you see. But the client is Mia Faye's sister. Mia trusted you. She knew her sister would be in good hands. Yes, of course, I know that. However, I'm sorry, but I must refuse. Sorry, goodbye. Creep? Fine. I don't have time to argue with you anyway. I'll go look elsewhere. Think not, huh? Did you say something? I think not, I said. What do you mean? I'm terribly, terribly sorry, but I'm afraid that no lawyer worth their salt will take on this particular case. Terribly sorry, my boy. Why? I cannot say. I beg your pardon, but could you leave now? I have nothing more to discuss with you. What's going on here? How do you know Mia Fae? She worked here a long time ago. Quite the appearance, that one. Learned my techniques in a blink of an eye. She left one day, quite suddenly. She had a mission, you see. A mission? You could see it in her eyes. She followed it with a burning passion. Never looked back, that one. That's quite a painting. Ah, you noticed. It's my pride and joy. Impressive, isn't it? Well, isn't it? The color of the sky, the hue of the sea, the weave of the straw hat. Every time it makes that noise, the controllers vibrate, so it's just funny. It's worth at least $3 million. I have no intention of parting with it, of course. No, I won't sell it. Not even to you. I wasn't interested. It's not for sale. I'm not buying. Jeez. Alright. I bet that other lawyer, the prosecutioner, is being pushy, paying off all the people. I can almost guarantee it. At least that's how I'm feeling right now about it. Interesting, interesting, interesting.
Nothing like some good old tomato soup and grilled cheese.
Some good stuff, guys. Lunch of champions. Just want everyone to know that. Alright, give me 1 second here. Find the lawyer? Well, what do I tell her? Well, see, just be honest. I really don't think you should use that guy. He didn't seem healthy. He was all skin and bones. What really happened? You don't mean he refused to help? I see. I've been abandoned then. Just a little longer now before the state-appointed lawyer comes, I guess. I made up my mind. I'm going to defend you whether you want me to or not. Why? Why? Well, no one is as sad as a person without any friends. I know. I've been there a long time ago. Oh! Why did I become a lawyer in the first place? Because someone has to look out for the people who have no one on their side. Maya, I won't abandon you. You can count on me. That's so kind of you. Sniffles. Well, let's fight this one and get you out of here. Right, thank you. Whew, she smiled at least. She looks like an entirely different person. One last question. You are innocent, right? Yes. And I trust you. So you trust me too, okay? Hey, Thermos, how's it going? File thump. It's a deal. So, what next? There's something that's been bugging me. Just what was inside the strange woman's drawer? It was when I tried to look into the drawer that she got all defensive. There has to be something in there. I feel it, man. I feel it. We need to figure out what case she was working on, too. Those like Detective Gumshoe has gone home. The police are still keeping themselves busy in the chief's office. No one has time to talk to me. Guess I'll head out. Okay, I guess we're going to the hotel again. Good afternoon, sir. Excuse me, you are... Ah, I beg your pardon, sir. I am the bellboy of this establishment at your service, sir. Oh, right. I just come up to deliver room service, sir. Do you know where Miss May might be? Ah, I believe our guest Miss May is currently using the, facilities. If you have no need of anything, I'll be taking my leave. Please, stay as long as you'd like. Enjoy. Yeah. Wait, no. Hey! Why does it seem like every time I come here, I end up embarrassing myself? Wait, now's my chance to snoop around a bit. Ah, I almost forgot. Gah! You came back quick! Might I ask you to inform Miss May that there is a message for her? Please tell her that Mr. White of Blue Corp phoned. Oh! Oh, right, sure. Mr. White of Blue Corp? Where have I heard that name? White. That was his name, my sister told me. Ho ho ho! White was the name of the guy who ruined Mia and Maya's mother. Could it be a coincidence? Go, 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 go! There's a screwdriver sticking out of the half-open drawer. Now's my chance to see what's inside. What do we have here? A wiretap? What would a woman like her be doing with a thing like this? Wiretap added to her court record. There is definitely something suspicious about Miss May. Why would she have something like this in her hotel room? There's a story behind all this. I know it. All right. I'll be using this bit of evidence in tomorrow's trial, that's for sure. For Maya's sake. I'll get to the bottom of this woman. Wait, I mean, you know what I mean. Oh, bellboy, still here? Uh-oh, time to scram. I look forward to Tan going with you tomorrow, Miss May. In court. To be continued. Bum, bum, bum. Wow. Well, that happened. that's disappointing. Why would they kill the waifu so fast? It's very upsetting. Okay, we have 15 minutes left. The question is do we have enough time to finish this out, or are we going to have to cliffhanger it? I think we're going to have to cliffhanger it, guys. Because I don't want to run into the time for Pokemon. So I think what we're going to do is we are going to stop here for Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney, and we're gonna cliffhanger you guys for until next week on the 2nd. Wow, what an interesting series. I like it. It's definitely like visual novel with like
some things in between. I wonder if you can do any, like, right or wrong answer or, like, game over or anything. Yeah, the Mr. White thing is interesting. I was hoping to get into the office so we could figure out what case that she was working on with the evidence. So, I don't know. I still think the sister... I'm a little concerned. So, it could have been a wiretap. And that's how that guy found out. But I feel like, I don't know, I'm still a little sus with the sister, in a way. But she's probably innocent. I don't know. but we are going to end that here. And we will be playing next week. We'll be playing a lot of stuff next week, actually. So we saved so I can close. So we'll be playing some Ace Attorney on the Switch. We'll also be playing what is it called? Pokemon Snap 2. Oh, man. So excited. Gonna be a good time. We all like that Pokemon Snap. All right, we're going to do this. We're going to do this. We're going to play some music here. And have a little intermission. Okay. We're going to get Pokemon set up, transferred over. I'm going to take a little break, eat some of my food here, grab some water, and like I said, get Pokemon set up. The stream is going to go down for a minute because I'm going to reset the stream, get our new title out, things like that. But it'll only be down for like no more than 30 seconds, and then I'll be right back. So give me about 2-3 minutes here, guys, and we'll be back and get into our Nuzlocke run and our Nuzlocke block, if you will, of the day. So we will see you in a few.